What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. So, everybody wants to know what the next project car is. Excitement is building. People are getting antsy. I'm getting antsy. Trust me, I have had many sleepless nights, but I am happy to announce that a deal has been made on a car. We're gonna go into more details on that in a future video, but I just wanted to let you guys know that the car will be here soon. So I just got off a phone call with the owner of the new project car. I am going to send him a check tomorrow. When he receives the check, he's going to send me the title, and then I'm going to schedule a transporter to go pick up the car and bring it here. So it is pretty exciting. I know a lot of you guys are just dying to know. I'm getting messages and emails daily about it. I have known what the car is going to be for months, and it has been driving me absolutely crazy that I can't tell you guys for a couple of reasons. One, because initially, I didn't want somebody to go find the car and buy it out from under me. And I'll tell you a little bit more why that is in a future video. Once you see the car, you're going to know why. Secondly, you know, we just got to build the tension here on YouTube so we can get you guys to come back and watch the videos. I know it's a little bit of a clickbaity type deal, but that's how it works. It's fun. It's exciting. It's like Christmas morning, waking up. You know, trying to see what is in the box, but I'm really excited. It's going to be a really cool project. I will give you guys a couple of hints, but nothing too crazy that's going to let you guys know what it is in today's video. I will tell you, you probably will find out within the next couple of videos. I'm actually going to the Long Beach Grand Prix this weekend, so there will be a video following up on that. I'm gonna kind of document a little things like I do every year that I go there. And then probably the video after that will be the reveal. So I'm pretty excited about that. So let's get into a couple of the hints. Nothing too crazy though. So as a lot of you guys know, I started out with a C5. About a year ago, I bought a 1988 C4 Corvette. Did a lot of different projects on that car. Probably posted close to 65, 66 videos with that car. That project turned out to be a really cool project. A lot of you guys were really interested in that. I've had a lot of feedback following the sale of that car. If you guys don't know, I did sell that car. That's why there's a vacant spot here in my garage. But following the days and weeks after selling that car, a lot of you guys said that you missed the C4 content. So it got me thinking, you know, as I was finishing up that car, I had in my mind that the next car was going to be a C3. And I searched around for different cars. I was trying to think of different ideas of what I could do with the C3. And that was a very real possibility. I could have done that. But I'm not. So you can scratch that one off the list. Not doing a C3. Probably the project following this next one will probably be a C3, unless something changes. I will do a C3 eventually, trust me, I'll get there. Might just take a little bit of time. But the next project will not be a C3. So there you go, there's the great reveal that it's not going to be a C3. If you guys wanted me to do a C3, I'm sorry, but that one's kind of on the back burner for just a little while. But we'll get there. We'll get there. Don't worry. I had quite a few people telling me that I should get a C8 or a C7. I just don't have the money for those cars. I mean, any decently optioned C8 is going to be around or over $100,000. I drive a C5, guys. I mean, this is a cheap car for what it is. I'm not making that kind of money yet. C7s are still depreciating assets, and honestly, they're holding their value quite well right now, thanks to the bit of inflation that we're seeing in the market. I don't expect that'll last forever, but you know, like a 2017, 18, 19 C7, they're sticking pretty close to their original MSRP, maybe about 10% less. But it's going to be quite a few years before those cars are relatively affordable, like the C5, C6, C4s. The other option that I had and still is a dream of mine is to get a C6 Z06. I've always loved that car. The 7-liter is really what makes that car. You guys might have seen I drove my buddy Matt's C6 Z06. It's got heads and cam package. Really the perfect street car, in my opinion. That thing was so much fun. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. I'll link it in the description below. Just the expression on my face said it all. And eventually I will get there. But again, you can cross that one off the list. That's not happening. In fact, I'm not getting a C6 at all. So it's not gonna be another C6. Or excuse me, another C6, not a C6, not another C6. I haven't had a C6 yet. So sorry. So it's not gonna be a C3. It's not gonna be a C6. And by the way, values of the C6 Z06 specifically, not all C6 models, but the Z06 specifically, probably the ZR1 has gone up slightly as well, but the Z06 specifically, from 12 to 14 months ago compared to now, I've seen the values go up around 40%. So for those of you that bought a C6 Z06 over a year ago, congratulations, because you just struck the lottery, my friend. Those cars are definitely going to hold their value for a while. Even when prices start to go down, I don't think they're gonna go down 40%. Not to where they were. I mean, you used to be able to buy not a high mileage Z06, but a higher mileage car for mid 30s. Now you're looking at 50, 55, maybe even 60 for a good one. They're way up there. So I don't know when that project's ever gonna happen, but again, it's on the back burner. The other option that I mentioned to you guys a while ago was maybe I get another C5 and do something completely different than what I did with my car here. So this car, if you guys haven't followed me for a long time, I've basically built my dream spec C5. I mean, this car is amazing. I mean, I've made it my own, but I really think that this is like the ultimate C5. Without going forced induction, this is probably as good as it gets, in my opinion. I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of people that don't like some of the things that I've done, but you know, that's your own opinion. You can build the car the way you want it. But the other option was to maybe I get another C5 and I do a completely different build. A lot of people were wondering maybe I should get a Z06. And I thought about that as well. In my opinion though, I honestly like the coupe better than the Z06. Don't tell my friends that own the Z06s, but coupe's better. So, yeah, I don't know. That maybe someday But that's another one that I think we can cross off the list for now. Maybe someday I'll do another C5 build. But if you guys haven't seen all of my videos, I probably have 300 or more specific videos on the C5 Corvette. So I have covered a lot of ground on C5 maintenance, how to, and different things. So go check out those videos. I've got them all on a playlist, easy to find. And maybe I can help you guys out on some of those things. So my ultimate project car would be a C2 Stingray. Even a C1 would be really cool, but the Stingray is like the quintessential Corvette. I would really love to restore one of those someday, but again, price is the big factor there. Even a barn find, just absolutely trashed C2 is gonna run 50 grand, and then you're probably gonna throw another 50 or more into it. So that is crossed off the list for now. C1, crossed off the list. So what does that leave us with? And on that bombshell, that is going to end today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. A lot more content is coming, so stay tuned for that. We'll see you guys later. Stay tuned.